Welcome back, everybody. Today I'm here to talk about The Walking Dead Season 10 and what we can expect, because Season 9 just wrapped up and they planted a lot of seeds throughout the season and the finale, and there's also interviews and confirmations of certain characters doing certain things. So we got a lot of stuff to break down and talk about and what we can expect in Season 10. So with that being said, if you are a fan of The Walking Dead, hit that subscribe button, but let's get started. So Season 9 ended in a very interesting way. You know, they just came off the pikes and the border and that horrible thing, and then it skipped a couple months into the finale. The groups are now united again. You know, there are certain characters who may have issues with other characters, but they're together now and they're willing to move forward from everything. And then it ended off in a very interesting way, and we heard a mysterious voice on the radio. And that's going to be the first thing we're going to talk about, because that's obviously, I think, the most exciting thing. And I think that was like a perfect cliffhanger. You know, it was, I don't even like, not even a cliffhanger really, it's kind of like a setup for the next season. So I thought that was done perfect. So at the end of the episode, like we saw, King Ezekiel was talking into the radio to Judith, and then as he walked away, we heard a woman, and it was a woman, and she said, "Hello, hello," calling out live on the open air, "Is anybody out there?" So we only saw it from the perspective of Ezekiel, because it cut to him getting up and walking away. But the other people, on the other hand, they might have heard it also, so that's going to be interesting to find out next season. But it's definitely a woman, so it wasn't Rick Grimes. I know that was a huge theory and a popular theory. Everybody wanted it to be Rick Grimes. I thought it would have been amazing if it was Rick, but I still think it could be connected with Rick, because Rick has to come back into the picture in some way in order for Michonne to leave, because that is also happening in season 10. So in the comics, the person they come in contact with is the Commonwealth, which it could still be the Commonwealth. But the reason, and it happens around the same time also, like near when they're getting ready for the Whisper War, Eugene comes in contact with a person named Stephanie. And this could be Stephanie, who knows? But the reason we don't know just for certain is because The Walking Dead is a universe now, right? The comic book is a comic book, but the TV show is like, it's not even like, it's a whole a franchise now. We got the main show, we got the spinoff, Fear the Walking Dead, they're developing another series, we got the movies, there are other spinoffs in the works, so it's a whole universe now, so it could be anybody essentially. But let's talk about the Commonwealth really quickly, because The Walking Dead is staying true to the comic, the main show at least, so the possibility of it being the Commonwealth is still very open. So it could be them, and I think the Commonwealth, they are going to come in season 10 most likely, because I don't see the Whisper War taking up a whole season. Like I don't know, I just don't see them doing another full season of a Whisper War, you know, especially if they were going to set this up in the finale of season 9. It obviously means it's going to come into effect in season 10, which would probably introduce whoever this is in season 10, if it is the Commonwealth, that is. And I don't think they would do it at the end of season 9 if it's not going to have a play in season 10. So I just see it with the Commonwealth, I kind of see them coming in like the second half of season 10. I kind of see the Whisper War lasting the first half of season 10 and that's it. And it wraps up in episode 8, and then the second half would be introducing the Commonwealth. But with that being said, it could still like last like 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 episodes, right? I just don't see it lasting. I actually think 12 episodes might be a good number for the Whisper War, right? Like 11, 12 episodes. And then the last couple episodes would slowly introduce the Commonwealth, and then the season 11 would be, you know, fully exploring them. But I still personally think it's going to be connected with Rick. The reason I think that is because Michonne is leaving in season 10. They already confirmed that the Night Guerrera's last season is season 10, but they, don't worry, they're trying to make it so she can work into the Rick Grimes movie. So she's definitely going to have a similar arc like Rick and Maggie did in season 9. So in order for her to leave and go to wherever Rick is, she needs to get like some sort of confirmation, like 100%, you know, indication that Rick is alive, because she is walking, like we saw in episode 14, her and Daryl, like they always walk around the area that the bridge exploded to look for his body. So they do that a lot, but you know, obviously Rick got taken away from a helicopter, so he went really far away. So you know, Michonne has two young kids, so in order for her to actually leave and go super far away, she needs to be 100% certain that he's alive. So that's already been confirmed, you know, formally it's been announced that she's leaving. But now the question is she going to take Judith and RJ? I personally think she's not going to take Judith and RJ. I mean, she may take RJ because he's a baby, but are they really going to recast Judith and actually give us a good actress and, you know, who can stand on her own? You know, Michonne doesn't even have to be there. We saw that with Negan in the last episode. Like, she's a good actress. Are they really going to make her leave too because Michonne is leaving? I don't think so. So what I think is going to happen is that Michonne is going to leave, and her plan is to go get Rick and come back. But obviously, we know that's not going to work out perfectly, and we're going to see that in the movies. And they're looking to begin production on the Rick Grimes movies this year. So that's going to be 2019, and they're going to most likely air it in 2020. And season 10 also begins filming in 2019, and Michonne is going to be in season 10 for a handful of episodes. That's what the word is, a handful. So again, I could definitely see like the same situation with Rick and Maggie, like maybe 6 episodes. Maybe they're gonna stretch it out to be like a half a season or something, and then after the Whisper War, because I don't see her leaving. You know, I feel like it'll be weird if she leaves in the middle of the Whisper War. That's why I also don't see the Whisper War lasting an entire season. I feel like she's gonna wrap up with the Whisper War, and then she's gonna leave. And I think it's going to be like the best ending, like that's going to be awesome for her to wrap up the Whisper War and then go find, you know, her husband. Like, how awesome would that be? But then again, going back to the Whisper War. So, we know the Whisper War is also going to happen in season 10. That's obvious. But right now it doesn't look like they're really aiming for a Whisper War, right? Like, even when they were crossing the border, they were, Ezekiel was like, you know, we don't want to trigger a war, but like the reason I feel like since he brought that up, like it's something they haven't discussed yet. Like it's not like they want to go to war, right? That's what he was cautious about. He's like, we don't want to trigger a war, guys. So that's why I kind of think that maybe Michonne could also leave before the Whisper War picks up. And now this could still happen. Who knows for sure? And the reason I say that is because I still feel like one more big death needs to happen in order for that Whisper War to happen. We'll see for sure though in episode or season 10 if they are already planning a Whisper War or are they gonna wait, because right now I feel like they are waiting. I don't think they want to go into war. I think they're just gonna be like, let's just mind our own business and do our thing. Even though Carol said like we didn't agree to those terms, I feel like they aren't gonna go like kill them all. Like, I don't know, maybe they could, who knows for sure, because the snow was there, the snow was holding them back, the weather was holding them back, so maybe that's why they didn't want to go. But we're gonna see in season 10. But that could also be the case where Michonne leaves because she doesn't think a Whisper War is gonna happen, and then after she leaves the Whisper War starts, because maybe like the first half of season 10 it could be this arc of Rick and Michonne leaving, and then the second half would be the Whisper War. That would be a very interesting way to do it, but I could still see it happen. And the more I think about this, I can kind of see it happening. Like, you know how people got like savior fatigue in season 8 in season 7 a little bit also? I think the same thing could maybe happen with the Whispers if they have an entire season of the Whispers. Even though the Whispers are far more interesting than the Saviors, I still think it's gonna that can still happen to fans, I feel like, if they overdo it. So maybe, you know, the Whispers are gonna be just MIA for the first 6-7 episodes, and then towards the end of, you know, the first half, they start coming back into the picture, they kill somebody again, and then that would trigger a Whisper War. That way it could do the same thing with season 9, where like maybe the first 6-7 episodes could focus only on Michonne and her journey and her decision to leave and go find Rick. So you guys let me know, what do you think is gonna happen? Like, what order do you think is gonna happen? When do you think Michonne is gonna leave? Let me know in the comments down below. But let's talk about Maggie for a second, because we also know she is gonna be returning in season 10, and that is also pretty much confirmed, because Angela Kang said that they are writing season 10 in one way, and that way is for Maggie to return. So they seem pretty confident in Lauren Cohan to return. Even though she isn't going to be returning full time, she's going to be there at least. So the last time we saw her was with Georgie, and you know, obviously Lauren Cohan had to leave also, that was some issues, so Georgie was a good way for her to leave. Now, Georgie is an interesting character, because I personally think Georgie is connected with the Commonwealth. I don't know for sure though, because if she's not connected with the Commonwealth, that's going to be a shit ton of groups we're dealing with. Again, it is a universe, so it makes sense. They could do it. But something about Georgie just tells me Commonwealth for some reason. I don't think Rick is connected with the Commonwealth, because Rick is going to be in his movies. And the Commonwealth is most likely going to be coming to the TV show. And since Maggie's coming back to the TV show, I think she's going to bring the Commonwealth with her. And like the attributes of Georgie and the group she comes from and how well they're, you know, carrying themselves and how well they're doing, I just feel like that would be a group connected with the Commonwealth. And some fans think that voice could have been Maggie. And that could definitely be the case, because obviously it is a woman, and it could be Maggie or Jadis, either or, but I mean, it could have been Maggie, who knows, because Maggie, like I said, it's been a couple months since the Pike, so Maggie most likely knew about the Pikes, because in the beginning of the episode, they mentioned how they were sending letters to Maggie, and they're communicating with Maggie, you know, they don't mention it every single episode, but they do it every once in a while, so you know, maybe Maggie found out about these Pike, you know, the people who died, like Jesus, Tara, Enid, like those are some of her closest friends. And then maybe she's trying to get in connection with them and, you know, like actually talk to them and figure out what's going on. And as far as Maggie returning, I see it happening after the Whisper War. So wherever that is, like if it's in the middle of the season or it's going to be at the end of the season, whenever that is, I just think at the end of the Whisper War would be the best time for Maggie to return. Because I don't see Maggie just randomly joining the Whisper War. She wasn't there when it begun. I mean, she would as a character. I feel like she would definitely want to fight the Whisperers because they killed her friends. But from a writing perspective, are you just going to write in Maggie to fight the Whisperers randomly? I don't see it happening. I feel like if she comes after the Whisper War, it'll be a great ending for fans and, you know, whatever that is, like a great ending for the arc, for the fans and the characters, because fans get Maggie back, characters get Maggie back, and then also she could introduce them to the Commonwealth, which is going to be the next group after the Whisperers. So let me know in the comments down below your thoughts, but that's the way I see it. I personally, overall, I think it's going to be connected with Rick, because nobody has a connection with Rick. So Rick has to come to them, or like, not Rick, like physically has to come to them, but like some sort of confirmation has to come to them that Rick is alive in order for Michonne to leave. I see Georgie as part of the Commonwealth, and I could totally be wrong about that, but I just think Georgie is part of that community. So Maggie is their connection to the Commonwealth, and she could come back and tell them about the Commonwealth. So that's why I think it's going to be connected with Rick, and then when they find out, that would set up Michonne's exit in Season 10. But let me know in the comments down below all your thoughts and opinions. I am going to wrap it up for this video. I don't want this video to go too long, but there's a lot more to talk about with this radio. We got interviews and a lot of stuff, so be sure to stay tuned for that. Angela Kang was teasing some stuff. Could be a connection with Fear the Walking Dead, so stay tuned for those videos. You know, even though it's the off season, we got a lot of stuff to cover. Rick Grimes movies news is coming out soon. We got another big announcement from Gimple that's coming out in the next week, so stay tuned for all that by hitting that subscribe button. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to leave a like. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys later.